If you are new to the channel, welcome. If you're not new, welcome back. Today we're going to be working on our very first part of our filament package series, and we are going to start with having two dashboards. Now, something that I first want to explain is that because filament is designed to be an admin panel or admins, it doesn't actually have two different dashboards. But what we can do is leverage it to create what looks like a separate dashboard. Let's go ahead into the documentation and take a look. In the filament documentation, if you go to the admin panel tab, that's pretty much where we are. If you go down to where it says dashboard and getting started, that's the page that we are currently on. This is really just going into explaining how to set up different widgets, and that's what we're going to do to leverage two dashboards. So if we come down to the customizing the dashboard page, it tells you here to basically create a new dashboard page, and then you want to remove the original dashboard class from the configuration file, and that's what we're going to do to set this up. A quick note on the code, the only thing that I've updated was in the vite-config.js, I wanted to add the server HMR host localhost so that it'll update the pages as we are using this. We'll close that out. That was the only change that I made. We'll go to the config folder, and then we'll go to the filament.php, and then we'll scroll down to where the dashboard is being pulled in from the filament configuration file, and we'll go ahead and just comment it out. Now you can delete it if you want to. I'm going to leave it here for the purposes of the demo. And we are done with that. So let's go ahead and close that. We'll open up the app folder, the filament folder, and in here, I'm going to create a new folder and I'm going to call it pages. In that folder, we're going to have another file and I'm going to call it dashboard.php. We'll go ahead and add our PHP up here. Namespace. The namespace will be app filament. Pages, because that's those are the folders that we are in. And we'll go ahead and create the class. This will be the dashboard class because that is the name of the file. What we want to do is we want to extend, well, we'll call it base page because that's the way it is in the documentation. The base page is actually from the filament pages dashboard. We are just going to rename it as base page so that we can have it extended. That should be good. Let's go ahead and make sure that we didn't break anything. It's already restarted, but just to show you how we're going to be working here, the admin is on the left side and the user is logged in on a different browser on this side. So let's just go refresh and make sure that we are still getting the exact same pages. Okay, good. So everything is the exact same. And as you can see, whether you're admin or a user, it's exactly the same thing. Fantastic. A way that I would like to use to distinguish between the users and the admins is to maybe have a post count. You know, we'll create posts in our database and stuff like that. And then we can see how many posts this particular user has. And then we should not be able to see it on here when we create our widgets. That's the goal of what we're going to do with the users. On the admin side, we are going to create some widgets that have basically the status of what's going on within the project. So let's go ahead and create the post resource for this user and we'll start there. So this is going to be very simple. The only thing that we are going to need is the migration, the model, and we'll use a factory for it too. We'll do sale artisan, make model, post, and we'll have the migration and the factory. And press enter and we should be good to go. Let's go ahead and start with the migration and get that up and running. Create posts table. And again, this is going to be super, super easy. So we'll do the foreign ID. And we'll just connect it to the user model, the user ID. We'll make it constrained. And then cascade on delete. And then we'll just need title, and we'll make a text field for the body. Okay, so let's go ahead and add the title and the body to the post model. I'll make it fillable, title, body, and we already have has factory here, so we're not going to need that. but then we'll open up the post factory so we can have some posts in our database already and create the resource for that. But before we do that, in the post model, I need the relationship for posts. And this is going to belong to the user. Go ahead and import that. And then also let's go ahead and make the relationship in reverse for the user. I'm not sure that we're going to use it, but we might. So we'll say has many. And these will be posts. Post. And we don't need the foreign or the local key. Import that. Okay, now let's deal with the factory. Because our users are from 1 to 5, right? We have 5 users, but their numbers are actually from 5 to 9 in the database. So if we take a look here, you see we have 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Those are the user IDs. Since we have 9, including admins, we can go ahead and do from numbers 1 to 9, and then all of them will have posts. But again, only the users will be able to see the count. In order to make sure that we can see that clearly, we are going to include users 1 through 9. So for the user ID, we are going to use this faker. And then we'll do number between 1 and 9. We're not actually creating new users. We are going to use the users that we have in the database already to create this. And then we have the title. We'll do this faker sentence, and that will give us a few words in the sentence. I think by default it is 6 words. Body equals this faker. And this will make a paragraph, which will be 3 sentences. Let's go ahead and add this to the database seeder so that we can get that going in the database. Now, instead of calling this again, I'm just going to go ahead and comment it out. And then we can do app models post factory. And then we're going to create, let's say 100. So again, we're not creating new users. We are giving the current users that we have. Well, instead of 100, I'm actually going to do 50. 100's a lot. And we should be good to go. So let's go ahead and run that migration. Sale, artisan, DB, seed. Did I name that incorrectly? Let's go and look. Oh, I had number here. That's not a thing. Let's try it again. I'm really falling off the thing here. Let's do migrate because I didn't do the migration for the post table. Let's try it again. We have finally seeded the database with the posts and we should be good to go. Okay, so let's go ahead and create that resource. We'll do sale artisan make filament resource, and this will be a post resource. And then we can also do the generate flag to have all of our fields filled out in our post resource. So let's go ahead and let that run. Okay, great. So let's close this and let's close all of these and go and check out that resource. So resources. We'll go ahead and refresh this. And as you can see, now we have the post resource. So we'll go ahead, create, edit, and let's open up the resource right down here. As you can see, we have our app models post. We have everything here. These are some basic information that we already have in the database. And that's why we're getting it when we ran the generate flag. All of that looks pretty good. Let's go and see what we have in both of our browsers. On the admin side, if we open that up, you see now that we have a posts link. And if we go on the user side, you can see that we also have the posts link. So we're going to go ahead to both of them just to see what we have going on. Let's see. We have the name. We can actually shorten the name a bit. We'll shorten the date. That should be good to go. We'll do the title and the body. We'll shorten those and then the date. Let's go ahead and work on that. In the title, Filament has a function, it leverages Laravel's limit function, and here we'll just do 10. There'll just be 10 characters, and then we can do the same for the body. And then the date time, I just want to use the format of date, month, and year. Let me copy that. And then we could do that for the updated ad as well. Okay, and that looks a little better so we can see more of it on the same page. But let's get back to the dashboard because that's why everybody is here. Again, we still have the same stuff. We haven't changed it yet. So let's go and work on creating some widgets for this user over here and get that going. If we go back to the filament documentation and go up to, on the left, we'll hit something called widgets. Under the getting dashboards, I want to go to the stats tab. Okay, and if we head down, this is how we would make an overview widget. So I'm just going to copy that and then we're going to adjust it for our needs. So in here, I'm going to go ahead, paste that in. I'm going to start by changing this from PHP to sale. And then instead of stats overview here, I'm going to call this one user widget. And we'll leave the flag of stats overview on there so that we can get the correct widget that we want. Optionally, we can attach it to a resource, but we don't want to do that. We just want a regular old widget. So that's created it. Let's drop this down and get rid of that actually. I'll open up the filament tab, and as you can see under here, we have a new folder called widgets, and here is our user widget. We're going to be using the stats overview widget, and it is extending the base widget. That's what the stats overview widget is. We're going to create a card. In this card, all I want to do is, well, we'll use card, we'll make, and then we'll just say your blog posts. And here I want to do auth user. Posts. And then I just want to get the count of that. Let's go ahead and see what we have in the browsers. If we go ahead and just refresh them, we should now see that we have some widgets on both of these. As you can see, the first one that loaded up was the user. We have our title of your blog post, and then we have three. We have the same thing for the admin, which is six for that particular admin. What I want to do is now hide that count from the admin side while still remaining on the user side. So if we come down under that function, we can do public static function. The function that we can use is canView. Now this is coming in from filament. So the only thing that we really need to do is to return auth user as role of user. Again, this is coming in from the permissions package that we have. The role that we are looking for is user. We have a function that is a Boolean function, and it's looking to see whether or not this user has the role of user. Let's go back and see what we get. Great. So now only the user can see the blog post count while the admin cannot see it. I want to show you an alternative to that, which is since we have an isAdmin field in our database, something that we can also do is return. We can say user is admin. Since we're looking for the user is not is admin, so we have to put an exclamation point here. You can now negate the user is admin, so if not authenticated user is admin. This exclamation point makes this function false. Okay, so let's see that and make sure that it still works. Okay, great. As you can see, it's the exact same thing. It's just a different function, just a different way of doing it. Pick which one you like. Good luck to you. So the next one I want to do is work on the admin side so that the user cannot see it. We'll open up the terminal and we'll run the same command except for now we'll do admin widget. It's asking us again if we want to attach it to a resource. We're just going to press enter and let it run. Now we should have our admin widget. So let's go ahead, refresh that. Here it is. What I'm going to do is I'm going to go ahead and paste in some different cards. Basically, we are just having unique views. If you saw the filament admin panel series, this is the exact same thing that we used in there. This is something that we should be able to see on the front end. So let's go and take a look at that. As you can see, we are logged in as the standard user on this side, and we can see that widget, and the same thing goes for the admin. So let's go ahead and now add that canView method to the admin and just put it in reverse. We can go ahead and grab this admin widget, paste it in. For this one first, we can get rid of this and make sure that we can only see it for the admin side. As you can see, on the standard user side, we cannot see it, and we can see it on the admin side. Let's go ahead and add that alternative also to the admins. And this one, instead of has role, we can do has any role. Super admin, admin, moderator, and developer, and it should work the exact same way. Again, users on this side can't see it. Admin on this side can see it. If you're enjoying the content, please go ahead and click that like button as it really does help out the channel. Here's a video YouTube thinks you'll like, and here's a playlist to follow along. Thanks for watching. I'll see you next time.